want to thank the SGA and the Men's Department for putting this very important topic. I think it's a topic we definitely need to discuss. It's something that's been hitting our communities in the past, this beginning of the year, and for the past several years. That being said, I'm gonna get right to it. The United States Department of Homeland Security defines the active shooter as an individual actively engaging in killing, attempting to kill people in a confined, populated area. In most cases, active shooters use firearms, but that's not necessarily all the case. Who remembers here in Cypher, we had a student with an exacto knife. So therefore, it's not only have to be firearms, it can be any weapon, but it has to be in the moment that they're attempting to kill or killing students. Chances are you will never find yourself in an active shooter situation. But everyone should take the time to prepare, take decisive action to improve chances of survival. Bridging the gap. There is a gap between the start of an active threat and the arrival of law enforcement. You must bridge that gap by being the immediate responders until police arrive. We in uniform, we're called first responders. However, and unfortunately, we cannot be at every spot at every moment of time. There's gonna be a time where you're on your own, in a classroom, in a theater, in a restaurant, okay? Everything we talk about today, and what we're gonna, the protocols we're gonna give you to prepare yourself if an active shooter situation happens or an active threat happens, don't always just think about university, a college. Take this wherever and everywhere you go. So bridging that gap, hoping it won't happen to me and hoping it won't happen here is not a good strategy. The key is you have to take action. You need to run, hide, or fight. You need to be committed to those actions and you need to make those actions happen because you're fighting for your survival. Not only are you fighting for yourself, but you're fighting for your family, your mom, your dad, brothers, sisters. You're fighting for everybody. It's not only just for you. But before you get to all that, like Dean Howard said, preventing an active threat starts with behavioral recognition. If you see something, you need to say something. Don't hold it in you. How many times have we heard in the news? Man, he told me that he was gonna do this, but I didn't believe it. I didn't think he was gonna go through it. I thought he was just kidding. We need to say something. 80 to 90% of aggressors usually give a tip to someone that they are going to do something. That someone needs to say something. And pretty much in closing here, as far as what I said here is, you want to be ready for an active shooter at all costs. You don't want to be a victim. You want to build a survival mindset. You want to know what actions you're going to take. You want to come out alive. That's your main focus on any active threat situation. Start with a survival mindset and situational awareness. Situational awareness, a skill that you can do better. Survival mindset is a protective shield comprised of three components. Awareness, preparation, and rehearsal. Awareness, gain a basic understanding of your situation. Be aware of your environment and any possible dangers. Take note of two nearest exits in any facility you visit. So for example, we're sitting here in a theater. Without even thinking, where are the two most nearest exits where you guys are right now? Awesome, great. We also have some back over here as well. So know your situation. Know where you're at all times. A lot of people tell me, hey, Captain Gomez, man, you're always so paranoid. It's not being paranoid, it's being aware. How many of us here have flown in a plane? Pretty much everybody. Does anybody like to hear here?
Yes, just in case the plane crashes, we're gonna go ahead and die.
Nobody likes to hear that, but what do they do every time you go ahead and get on a plane? They go over the procedures. If the plane does go down, this is what you need to do. Here are the exits, So what they're doing is preparing. They're rehearsing, right? Nobody likes to hear that. This is the same topic. This is a topic that I've been discussing for about 5 or 6 years, and trying to discuss this, but a lot of people say, no, that sounds too scary. You know, we don't want to talk about that. You know, it might scare the students, it might scare people, but you know what? This is reality. And what we need to do is we need to educate everybody on how to take care of themselves. Because at the end, like I said, law enforcement, we're not in your back pocket. I wish we were, believe it or not. Hey, there's a problem happening here. Throw the police out there. But we're not. So you need to be that immediate responsible. Next, predetermined mindset will help you take rapid, effective actions. So the next step is preparation. Looking at your workplace or wherever you're at, environment through the lens of survival. Let's not just nonchalantly go to an area and just sit there. I mean, look what happened in Aurora, the theater, right? It's happening everywhere. Restaurants, it's happening in the churches. Who would think that you go to a church and you're gonna have to confront an active shooter? No, but we need to be prepared at all times. So do the what ifs. I think this one's very important. I play what ifs myself, with my officers, even at home, even with my kids and my wife. Say, okay, we're here in the restaurant. All right, what if somebody comes in here, what are you guys gonna do? It's not being paranoid. It's just preparing yourself for when a situation does happen, you're not stuck. You know what to do and how to take care of business. Survivors prepare themselves both mentally, emotionally, to do whatever it takes to survive. So we're talking about rehearsal. Mentally or physically, practicing your plan. How many of you here remember what a Rolodex is? Okay, for those of you who don't know what a Rolodex is, I have to put that picture in there because I think I would probably come across somebody who did not know what a Rolodex is. So think of your brain as a Rolodex. What does a Rolodex contain? Information, context, right? So when you're looking for something, you roll the Rolodex, boom, here's what I'm looking for, you put it out, and you're done. So your brain, think of your brain as a Rolodex. If you don't give yourself that experience or rehearse a situation or a problem, that Rolodex is just going to keep on spinning. So that spinning, what causes is for you to freeze. So if a situation happens and I freeze, it's because my brain is trying to gather what should I do next. But if we prepare and if we rehearse and we put information in that Rolodex, so when a situation does happen, that Rolodex turns maybe once or twice, stops, and says, ooh, I remember that. Let me pull that information out, and then you take action. Studies have shown that just by you mentally preparing yourself, physically going all the what ifs, what if this happens, what if this happens, you pretty much, the brain will take it like if you've done that action before, or you've had that experience. So you will not freeze, which a lot of people do. If they freeze, they don't know what to do. So very important to rehearse, mentally train. I told my officers this, unfortunately, we don't get the chance to physically train every day on how to prepare for an active shooter, not even on a weekly basis. So what I tell them is, hey, when you're walking around the halls, mentally train yourself. If this were happening to this hallway, this is what I would do, this is what you do, this is the action you would take. So when it does happen, we're not freezing, we're taking immediate action. Remember, shootings can occur anytime, anywhere, to anyone. Again, let's not get stuck with, well, I hope this doesn't happen to me. I hope this doesn't happen here. Because hope is not a strategy to take. Bottom line, you need to take direct responsibility for your personal safety and security. So here's one, remain calm. Like, wow, how do I remain calm in a situation like this? Well, we as first responders, we use this right here. It's called combat breathing. Some people call it tactical breathing. This is used in the military. This is used for sports. This is used for people like, you know, they get nervous at a time. It's called combat breathing. So this is a little exercise I want everybody to do here. Breathe in through your nose, counting 1, 2, 3, 4. Stop and hold your breath for 1, 2, 3, 4 seconds. Exhale, counting again, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you do it about 3 to 5 times,
Besides getting lightheaded?
Your heart rate will go down drastically. And you will have the time to understand what's going on in that minute, that second. Staying calm helps. You can think more clearly. Everyone in the victims remain calm. Because if you, as a, let's say a professor, are nervous wreck, or you're not calm in a situation like that, guess what? Everybody's gonna see that and they're not gonna be calm. They're not gonna be calm yet. Just like in the airplane. If it starts shaking a lot or it starts dipping down, I always look at the stewardess. And if they're crying and yelling, guess what? I'm in panic mode. I'm like, wait a minute. If she's crying and yelling, then guess what? Something's wrong. So it's pretty much the same concept. I put here allocate tasks. Because in a situation where there's an active threat going on and everybody's worried, if you start giving somebody tasks, hey, do me a favor, I need you to hide over here. Go ahead and block that door. Let's go ahead and barricade this. You're taking the mind away from what's happening in that media second and you're giving them a task to do. So kind of keep their mind busy. Okay? So how to respond? The role of faculty, staff, and students. Again, run, hide, and fight. I put in the bottom, avoid, deny, and defend, because there's other programs out there that throw their gist to it. So we follow both of these. Run, hide, fight, avoid, deny, defend. How many of you have seen the run, hide, fight video that's been out there for several years already? Great, good, good. This video here, what we're gonna show you, it's a video that was actually recorded in university, and I think it fits us perfect, because it's gonna tell you from point A all the way to the last point of what to do and how to prepare yourself and how to react for an active shooter situation.